Hey, I'm back. I wanted to tie in what we talked about last time. I've got a video on the solstice, particularly the winter solstice, and I wanted to tie that in with the Tropic of Capricorn, the Tropic of Cancer, and the Tropic of the Equator. So I've got this diagram right in here, and it's called an analemma. Now this is our winter time right in here, and this analemma tells us where the sun's directly overhead on any day. So I put winter down here for a sticker on December 21st or thereabouts. It's within a day or two. Leap year kind of messes with us. So I'm going to always use the 21st. December 21st, that's where this winter solstice is. Now, as we move on around here, I'm into January. We're heading toward the spring. And the sun, as it shows on this chart, is directly overhead at the equator when spring starts. And let's say March 21st or thereabouts. Let's continue up this chart. It goes up to the Tropic of Cancer. This would be June 21st or thereabouts. And then it snakes on around, continues on. And then, let's say in the fall, when I had another video, there's where the sun is over the equator in the fall. Let's say that is September 21st or thereabouts. And then you can come back to the solstice, the winter solstice. Okay, so first of all, a couple things about it. One is that the days haven't really changed much in their length. You can see that right in here. As the sun gets closer to us, the days lengthen. We get longer. And for about 2 months now, we really have not changed the length of day. Now, when we come around the corner here toward the spring, let's say in February, February 14th, that is Valentine's Day. That really means our length of days are going to get longer. And that makes me pretty excited, okay, because it's been fairly dark. And I wanted to talk about, though, the second real use of this, which was for navigation, particularly for mariners out at sea who could not tell, you know, where they were. They had no indication whatsoever. So I wanted to show you something over here on the back. All right, so if we look right in here, all right, this shows us the sun and it shows us the earth. The sun's directly overhead, always somewhere, right? And on April 10th, 15th, that is, I looked at the chart here. It shows that it's at 10 degrees north of the equator. So if I were looking at the sun, it's directly overhead, I looked at the chart, hey, I know where I am. I'm directly underneath the sun. I'm at 10 degrees north of the equator. Now, it's not always going to be that easy, is it, right? So I wanted to show you another example here. So rather than it being directly overhead, let's say it's at 80 degrees. I'm going to turn around and watch this myself. So it's 80 degrees instead of 90, right? Instead of directly overhead. Now 80 plus 10 is 90, right? Now this number here is going to be important. We've got this formula that we could use to figure this out, or we could just simply look at two charts here. One is this one, and I got a 10, right? It's basically dropped 10 degrees from the vertical. And I go over to here, my little diagram. So I'm not directly underneath it. I'm either 10 degrees this way or 10 degrees that way. So I could be 10 degrees north of where the sun is. It says 10 degrees north of the equator plus 10. So that's 20, right? 20 degrees north of the equator. That could be my location. Or I could be 10 degrees, subtract 10 from 10, that's 0. I could be at the equator on April 15th. So if you think about it, it's really not that complicated. The Earth is curved. If I'm not directly underneath the sun, let's say I'm about 10 degrees south of it or north of it, you know, it's going to be a different answer. But I just wanted to show you guys that you can use this analemma for fun things like the length of day as well as for navigational purposes. So that does it for a talk about the analemma.